This is not the conversation I thought we were having today, and I feel very uncomfortable.
No. I'm just following about something to get an understanding from you.
Yeah, but I feel uncomfortable. Like, this tape's going to go out in the world, and some of these things that we're saying don't make me feel comfortable at all.
But you write about them, and you talk about them, so I just want a better understanding, because I'm black and slow. A lot of things I just don't understand. That's all.
I don't feel comfortable.
All right, relax. We're doing fine.
No, I know I'm doing fine. I'm saying I don't feel comfortable.
Oh, but relax.
So I'd like a producer, whoever that is, to pause tape. I'm not going to do this interview right now. It doesn't feel comfortable to me.
But all I'm doing is following up on what you've said to get an understanding why you feel so uncomfortable.
I feel uncomfortable that if, when we put this in the world, it might not be clear what my point of view is.
No,
it
you're very clear.
And I'm not kidding. I'm not talking anymore until they stop the tape and we take a break.
Well, relax. We'll just, and see if you still feel uncomfortable. Let me know, all right?
I'm not going to do this right now.
Oh, so are you saying that you don't want to...
I'm saying I'm done today.
Oh,
I think I said it three times now. I'm not talking today about this. If we want to try again, we can. I can send you questions that make me feel comfortable. So far, it doesn't feel like a good conversation.
I have with me Reverend Dr. Jackie Lewis. She is the senior minister of Middle Collegiate Church in New York City. Amazing. She's also the author of Fierce Love, A Bold Path to Ferocious Courage. Dr. Lewis, thanks for coming on. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Jesse Lee. Appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you. When you mentioned ferocious courage, do you have fear?
Do I have fear?
Yes.
Oh yeah. Absolutely, I have fear.
And why do you have fear?
I'm afraid that I could be standing on any corner with my grandbabies. Somebody having a bad day will see me and my little mocha chocolata babies and just think, I'm going to shoot them.
So is that why you moved away from Chicago? You were afraid of getting hurt by some black people?
No.
Who were you afraid of then with the guns?
White guys with mostly white guys with guns.
So you are not afraid of the blacks killing, because you lived in Chicago for a while, right?
I grew up in Chicago. I'm not afraid of black people.
Why not? Why are you not afraid? So many blacks are getting killed by blacks. Why are you not afraid of that?
I'm not afraid of the kind of personal violence that can happen that I wish wouldn't happen as a clergy, as a revolutionary lover. I'm not afraid of that. I'm not afraid of boys on the corner acting out. I'm afraid of assault-style weapons being purchased by 18-year-olds who are being taught hatred on the internet, and they go out and do something about it.
That's amazing. Why is the cultural divided?
Mm-hmm. Why is it divided?
Yes.
Not enough of us have had the courage to have conversations across the divisions that would make us one people. We haven't had enough conversation.
Do you agree that if it wasn't for the white people finding and creating the greatest country, there would be no America? No, we would not be here. We would be somewhere else. You agree to that?
This land was called Turtle Island by the indigenous people. So no, it wasn't America.
Really?
But it could have had a different trajectory. It could have been different.
So if Columbus had not found or discovered, however you want to call it, and then got together with some other white men and with the help of God and created the greatest country on this country. You notice everybody and their mama trying to come here. It's not like it's not the best place. Would there be an America?
There would be something.
But it wouldn't be America, right?
No.
Amazing. Are you grateful for that?
Am I grateful for
that they did found and created the greatest country on this side of heaven, America, that the white man did do that? Are you grateful for that?
No.
Why not?
Because I'm embarrassed. I'm ashamed that this land was stolen I'm ashamed that my ancestors were kidnapped and built it. And I'm ashamed that white supremacy still hijacks the agenda here.
Oh, can you define white supremacy for me? Because I don't know what that means. Because I hear a lot of Black people calling white people white supremacists. And from, in my mind, it sounds like they believe that white people are superior to them.
Well, that's not what it means.
What does it mean then?
It doesn't mean that I, as a Black person, think the white people are superior. It
so
means
why would you use that word, the white supremacist?
Can we just,
you believe that.
No, it doesn't imply. Can we stop for a minute?
Yes.
This is not the conversation I thought we were having today. And I feel very uncomfortable.
No. I'm just following about something to get an understanding from you.
Yeah, but I feel uncomfortable. Like, this tape's going to go out in the world, and some of these things that we're saying don't make me feel comfortable at all.
But you write about them, and you talk about them, so I just want a better understanding, because I'm Black and slow. A lot of things I just don't understand. That's all.
I don't feel comfortable.
All right, relax. We're doing fine.
No, I know I'm doing fine. I'm saying I don't feel comfortable.
Oh, but relax. So
I'd like our producer, whoever that is, to pause tape. I'm not going to do this interview right now. It doesn't feel comfortable to me.
But all I'm doing is following up on what you've said to get an understanding why you feel so uncomfortable.
I feel uncomfortable that if when we put this in the world, it might not be clear what my point of view is.
No,
it
you're very clear.
And I'm not kidding. I'm not talking anymore until they stop the tape and we take a break.
Well, relax. We'll just and see if you still feel uncomfortable. Let me know. All right.
I'm not going to do this right now.
Oh, so are you saying that you don't want to?
I'm saying I'm done today.
Oh,
I think
you are?
I said it three times now. I'm not talking today about this. If we want to try again, we can. I can send you questions that make me feel comfortable. So far, it doesn't feel like a good conversation.
I'm a little surprised to hear you say that, because you said that one of the problems with culture is that we don't sit and agree and disagree and talk about things anymore.
Yeah.
You said that they tend not to do that. It looked like you're about to do the same thing.
I'm about to stop talking because I could go to any room in the world, any room in the country, any room. I also get to have the ferocious courage to say, I'm not comfortable. So I'm not comfortable right now.
I know, but you're not showing ferocious courage by running.
I'm not running. I'm just not comfortable. And
well,
I'm not
what does
do
that
right
mean
now.
You're not comfortable? I don't know what it means.
I think it means that I'm not comfortable. It doesn't feel like it's a good dialogue right moment, this moment. And I would like to pause. It doesn't feel comfortable to do it right now.
Amazing.
Like the product isn't going to represent what I'm trying to say. It doesn't feel that way.
But you're clearly saying what you're trying to say, and I'm just getting a better understanding to understand. Because you're helping me to understand the culture better.
If we're going to do it again, then I would send questions that help you know what do I mean by white supremacy? What are the terms that I'm trying to use? And what's the message I'm trying to put in the world? I'm trying to put in a world a message of ferocious courage that allows for good conversations. And I'm also a human. And I'm saying this conversation doesn't feel to me like it's going how I would like it to go.
So before you run, can I ask you about some other part? Before you run, can I ask you about some other part of your book?
Not today.
Amazing.
I want to have a dialogue.
That's what we're doing.
Jesse Lee, I'm not going to talk more right now about it. I don't feel like it's going well, and I would like to stop.
Well, can we at least talk about you being a minister and what that life for you?
I'm a minister, and I'm an activist, and I'm standing up for myself right now and saying this doesn't feel comfortable.
What made you decide to become a minister?
I had 1 hour scheduled for this, and it's 3 minutes to 1 hour now. So it feels like it's not going to go as well as you or I would like. And I'd like us to pause and see if we can get it on the calendar again. That's what I'd like to do.
Well, I can't force you to stay, of course. I am a little surprised that you're running, but
there's a connotation to running that doesn't feel comfortable. That's not what I'm doing. It's not going well. We're going to stop.
Can I at least ask you one more question before you go?
That depends on what it is.
About Obama. You mentioned Obama earlier. Can I ask you something about him?
We'll see. Go ahead, ask it. We'll see if I'm going to answer it.
You mentioned some about the president starting an insurrection, causing an insurrection. And I want to know, were you surprised when Obama caused the insurrection by using
Obama
Black
didn't
Lives
cause
Matter?
An insurrection. Obama didn't cause an insurrection.
Well, when you said...
I was talking about Trump.
Oh, you're talking about Donald Trump? Oh, I thought you meant Barack Obama. Remember when Black Lives Matter were chanting...
I'm seriously, I did not imply that the President Obama had an insurrection.
Oh, I thought when you
That's
said the
you
president...
Saying that. No, you didn't think that. I'm
yes, I did.
Now.
I was thinking about when Black Lives Matter would chant.
I'm really sorry that I'm going to go, but I really am going to go. And whoever plays this cuts it up. If I see it in the world without having to approve it, I'm not going to be happy.
No, we're not going to cut it up. We'll present it as is.
We're not going to present. We're not going to play this tape anywhere.
Well, you might not be able to play it, but I'm playing it.
No, you're not going to play it.
Yes, I am going to play
it. As well.
I'm sorry?
Why are you going to play something that didn't go well?
I mean, it's going well as far as I'm concerned. I thought we were having an amazing dialogue. I didn't expect you to
run. You're not having an amazing dialogue. You are misinterpreting what I'm saying.
I'm not interpreting it at all. I'm just asking questions.
Feels like on purpose.
I'm just asking questions.
Beautiful people in the world, if you hear this, I'm Jackie Lewis. I'd love to talk with you later.
She ran.